Sydney, and we are going to talk about rubella. So your loved one has been diagnosed with rubella, and rubella is often known as German measles or three-day measles, and this is a viral infection that's characterized by a rash that is red in color. And this virus is not very common and often rare in places like the U.S., but it can cause serious problems in places where there are few people who are vaccinated, especially for expectant mothers. So here are some causes for rubella. So rubella starts by infecting the cells in the respiratory tract, so the throat and lungs, and it grows in these places. And it's often caused by direct contact, which is person-to-person contact. So your loved one may have come in contact with another body fluid or mucus from someone who is infected with rubella. Another type of transmission or method of spreading of rubella is through droplet transmission. And this is when someone sneezes or coughs and these droplets of the virus are present in the air. And often people can cause the spread of rubella without realizing it in these cases. And in other cases, rubella can also be spread through the bloodstream. So this is a bloodborne transmission, but this is often in pregnant mothers as they spread it to their baby. So rubella also has a very long incubation period or time period that the disease spreads. And in many cases, the rubella virus can be carried and spread to others for 1 to 2 weeks before a rash appears in the individual and up to 2 weeks after the rash disappears. So because of this, someone could spread the disease to the person without even realizing that they have it. Your loved one may also have contracted rubella from traveling abroad in countries where the rubella vaccine is not available. So your relative may be experiencing a variety of symptoms, and these will usually appear about 2 to 3 weeks after they've been exposed to the virus. And many of these symptoms are very general. So by themselves, it can be difficult to diagnose rubella. And sometimes people will confuse rubella with measles. But the telltale symptom is usually the pinkish rash that starts, and it usually starts as fine dots, and it starts on the face, and then it spreads to other parts of the body, like the trunk, the arms, and the legs, and even onto the feet. And this rash will usually fade within 5 to 6 days, and it will disappear the same way that it appeared. And then part of the rash also will include spots in the mouth, and these are called coplex spots, and they disappear as the rash disappears. And then some of the other symptoms are fever, headache, stuffy or runny nose, red eyes, aching joints, sore throat, or tender joints. And then for diagnosis, there are additional. Okay, so for diagnosis, it can be difficult to diagnose due to the symptoms that are similar. It can be difficult to diagnose due to the symptoms that are really similar to other diseases. And rubella can sometimes be misdiagnosed as measles because of the similarities between these two. So the doctor will perform some laboratory tests, like a virus culture and blood tests. And the blood test will look for antibodies in the blood of the rubella virus. And then also the doctor will perform a physical exam so that he can identify the rash on your relative and make sure that it is rubella. And this will play an important role in diagnosis. So then some risks for rubella. There are additional risks involved in contracting rubella, specifically for pregnant women. So when a pregnant woman contracts rubella, the virus is passed to the baby through the bloodstream. And this has severe consequences. So often this can cause a stillbirth or a miscarriage, but it can also cause quite a few different birth defects. And these are categorized under congenital rubella syndrome. So aside from the risk for miscarriage, congenital rubella syndrome can also cause other birth defects, such as delayed growth, intellectual disabilities, heart defects, deafness, or poorly functioning organs. And then other risks for those who are not pregnant would include encephalitis, and this is inflammation in the brain, and it's also a complication that that can occur in any individual after they have contracted rubella. And then also bleeding problems can occur as a complication. So then for treatment, the measles vaccine can be given up to 72 hours after exposure to rubella. And this will help the symptoms. And in addition, immunoglobulin can be given within 6 days after exposure, and this can lessen the severity of the disease. There's no treatment that will really shorten that virus, and it has to run its course once it's contracted. But adults can be given aspirin, and children can be given Tylenol to help alleviate some of the symptoms like fever and headache. And bed rest can also be beneficial to your loved one, and it's important to make sure they receive plenty of fluids. And it's also important to isolate your loved one, especially if they're pregnant, or especially if they're around women who are pregnant, because rubella can cause so many complications in pregnancy, and also it's very spreadable. So the good news is that after having rubella, your loved one will have permanent immunity. And after most symptoms are absent, the rash may leave some brownish spots, and there could be healing that lasts for up to a few weeks. And some women do experience arthritis in their fingers and knees for about a month after they contract rubella. If your loved one has a prolonged headache, earache, or a stiff neck, they should see a doctor immediately to make sure that ear infection has not developed or they have not developed encephalitis. But after the symptoms are gone, there's no need for a follow-up visit. So if you would like more information, these are our sources. Let us know if you have any questions about how you can support your loved one. Thank you.